Om Hari Om Tat Sat Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om Om Sada Shiva Samarambha Vyasa Shankara Madhyama Asmadacharya Paryantam Vande Guru Paramparam Shruti Smriti Purananam Alayam Karunalayam Namami Bhagavat Pada Shankaram Loka Shankaram Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Kritau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmeti Murti Bheda Vibhagine Jomavad Vyakta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha Om Sahana Bhavato Sahana Bhunakto Sahaviryam Karavavahai Tejasvinavadhitamastu Mavidvishavahai Om Shanti 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 Om Shanno Mitra Shambarunaha Shanno Bhavatvaryama Shanna Indra Brihaspatihi Shanno Vishnu Rurukramaha Namo Brahmane Namaste Vayo Twameva Pratyaksham Brahmasi Twameva Pratyaksham Brahma Vadishyami Ritam Vadishyami Satyam Vadishyami Tanmahavatu Tadvaktaramavatu Avatu Maam Avatu Vaktaram Om Shanti 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 Om Yaschandasam Rishabho Vishwarupaha Chandobhyo Dhyamruta At Sambhava Samendro Medhaya Asprunotu Amrutasya Devadharano Bhoyasam Shariram Me Vicharshanam Jihva Me Madhumattama Karna Abhyam Bhodi Vishruvam Brahmana Koshosi Medhaya Pihitaha Sorry. Shrutam me gopaya Om Shanti 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 Aham Vrikshasya Reva Kirti Prishtan Gire Reva Urdhva Pavitro Vajini Vasvamrutamasmi Dravinam Savachasam Sumedha Amrutokshitaha Iti Trishanko Vedano Vachanam Can repeat after me. Aham Vrikshasya Reva Aham Vrikshasya Reva Aham Vrikshasya Reva Aham Vrikshasya Reva Kirti Prishtan Gire Reva Kirti Prishtan Gire Reva Kirti Prishtan Gire Reva Kirti Prishtan Gire Reva Urdhva Pavitra Tro Vajini Vasvamrutamasmi Urdhva Pavitro Vajini Vasvamrutamasmi Urdhva Pavitro Vajini Vasvamrutamasmi Pavitra Vajini Vasvamrutamasmi Dravinagam Savarchasam Dravinagam Savarchasam Dravinagam Savarchasam Sumedha Amrutokshitah Sumedha Amrutokshitah Sumedha Amrutokshitah
Sumedha Amrutokshitah
Iti Trishankor Vedano Vachanam
Iti Trishankor Vedano Vachanam
It is Start chanting the 11th anuvaka.
Vedamanuchacharonte vasina manushasti
Vedamanuchacharonte
vasina manushasti Vedamanuchacharyonte vasina manushasti
Vedamanuchacharyonte
vasina manushasti Satyam vada
Satyam vada
Dharmanchara
Dharmanchara
Swadhyaya anma Pramadah
Svadhyaya Atma Pramadah
Acharyaya Priyam Dhanamahritya Prajadantum Mapyavachetsihi
Acharyaya Priyam
Mapyavachetsihi Acharyaya priyam dhanamahritya prajatantum mapyavachetsihi
Acharyaya
priyam dhanamahritya prajatantum mapyavachetsihi Vedamanuchacharyonte vasina manushasti Vedamanuchacharyonte vasina manushasti Satyam vada
Satyam vada
Dharmanchara
Dharmanchara
Swadhyaya anma pramadah Swadhyaya anma pramadah Acharyaya priyam dhanamahritya prajatantum mapyavachetsihi
Acharyaya
priyam dhanamahritya prajatantum mapyavachetsihi Acharyaya priyam dhanamahritya Prajatantum mapyavachetsihi
Acharyaya priyam dhanamahritya prajatantum
mapyavachetsihi Satyanna pramaditavyam
Satyanna
pramaditavyam Satyanna pramaditavyam
Satyana pramaditavyam
Dharmanna pramaditavyam
Dharmanna
pramaditavyam Kushalanna pramaditavyam
Kushalanna
pramaditavyam Bhutyena pramaditavyam
Bhutyena pramaditavyam
Swadhyaya pravachanabhyam na pramaditavyam
Swadhyaya pravachanabhyam na pramaditavyam
Swadhyaya pravachanabhyam na pramaditavyam.
Svadhyaya pravachanabhyam na pramaditavyam.
Svadhyaya pravachanabhyam.
Svadhyaya
pravachanabhyam na pramaditavyam.
Pramaditavyam
Deva Pitru Karyabhyam na pramaditavyam.
Deva
Pitru Karyabhyam na pramaditavyam.
There's a long vowel. Pitru Karyabhyam, Pravachanabhyam, not short.
Deva Pitru Karyabhyam na pramaditavyam.
Deva Pitru Karyabhyam na
pramaditavyam. Matru Devo Bhava.
Matru Devo Bhava.
Pitru Devo Bhava.
Pitru Devo Bhava.
Acharya Devo Bhava.
Acharya Devo Bhava.
Atithi Devo Bhava.
Atithi Devo Bhava.
So until now, we have seen the Panchamahayagyas and the attitudes that we should have towards our parents and teachers, and still same topic of what should be our attitude towards even others. Let me conclude here. So whenever doubt comes, what I should do, what I should not do, then always you take the scripture as the pramana. So to know in a given situation what I should do, how I should do, what I should not do, if this doubt arises, what is the source of knowledge? What is the means of knowledge? Especially for a spiritual aspirant, for a jignyasu, for a mukshu, for the one who is very clear and who is committed to the pursuit of moksha as the ultimate goal, and for the one who is committed to the pursuit of knowledge of the truth, the Lord, as the ultimate goal, for whom knowledge of the truth and Lord and the moksha are identical. And for such a person who lives his life doing all his religious activities and other mundane activities in conformity with dharma, just to prepare his mind for knowledge. In situations when doubt arises, what is the pramanam? What is the means of knowledge? What is the source of knowledge? Such a question, the answer is shrutihi. For knowledge of dharma, what is appropriate and inappropriate? So that, first of all, dharma shastram, which is the karma kanda of the Veda, is the means of knowledge of dharma. For jnanam, for mokshaha, Vedanta jnana kanda of the Veda is the pramana. For knowledge of the truth, knowledge of the truth, to understand the oneness of the truth of the individual, the universe and the Lord, Jiva, Jagat, Ishvara, Swarupa, Aikya, Jnanartham. For that, Vedanta, the Jnana Kanda is the means of knowledge. Whereas for knowledge of right and wrong action, for knowledge of dharma, knowledge of moksha, Jnana Kanda, knowledge of dharma, the pramana is karma kanda of the Vedaha. So shutihi. Shutihi is one word, another word for Vedaha. You say shuti granthaha means karma kanda portion of the shuti Veda is the means of knowledge. The first is authentic source of knowledge of dharma. And the second means of knowledge is smriti granthaha or smritihi. The word smritihi literally means memory. But smritihi is also a name of the texts. There are many texts which are written by other rishis and acharyas. And these smriti granthas, all those texts which come under the category of smriti, all of them present the subject matter of the shruti without distorting it. That is why smriti granthana is equally revered as shruti. Even though shruti is the most authentic source of knowledge, shruti is the most authentic source of knowledge, but smritihi is also smritihi, shrutihi smritihi, okay? Smritihi is also equally revered as the scripture, because smriti granthas also present the teaching of the shruti without distorting it. But the abstract facts, very subtle teaching, very subtle themes which are really hiding and then which are implicitly presented or which are elaborately scanned all over the shruti are very beautifully presented through personification of facts, even devatas, and still stories and explanations. The same subtle factors, subtle facts, subtle themes, abstract ideas of the Shruti are taught, reproduced in the Smriti, and taught through stories and explanations. So it's easy for even an ordinary person to understand those values highlighted in abstract facts revealed through stories from the Smriti. So the person who is exposed to the Smriti also understands the contents of the Shruti easily. That's why you all know even Bhagavad Gita is considered to be, is said to be Upanishad, Brahma Vidya, Yoga Shastram. Because subject matter of Bhagavad Gita is subject matter of the Vedanta. But in all of Puranas, Vyasacharya has done 36 Puranas, 18 Mahapuranas, 18 Upapuranas, and we have Ramayanam, Mahabharatam. There are also other lot of smriti texts. Many rishis, they were all written by other people, acharyas and rishis, but still they all reproduce the subtle ideas through stories, through explanations. Therefore, others also who cannot access the Vedic Shastra also can understand this Vedic teaching through smriti. So smriti is also for us another authentic source of knowledge of dharma, knowledge of right and wrong. And a third source of knowledge, Shastra itself, Veda itself recommends, it is the Sishta Acharaha. Sishtaha means a person of profound knowledge of scriptures and whose life is being always lived in keeping with Vedic way of, with injections of Veda Shastram, or whose life itself aligns to the Dharma Shastra. Life itself aligns with Dharma Shastra. Because this person, having been practicing for very long, the Shastra teaching just becomes is a spontaneous expression of his in his actions. Life itself aligns with Shastra. And such a person who has performed not just the Shastrams and who is committed to a life of values, as I said, he himself is another Shastra. So the touch Sishtachara Purushanam, even Jivita, in the life of such people, Mahatmas, also can be observed and can be taken there, from their behavior also, we can take, can have knowledge of what is appropriate, what is inappropriate in situations. These three sources are there for us as means of knowledge of Dharma. Now, so here the Shruti is going to say, when we have to do things, what should be followed? Suppose the teacher, our own teacher who teaches Dharma, we can follow teacher, we can follow Smriti, and we can follow Shruti. Of the three also, among the three sources of knowledge also, definitely suppose if the Smriti or the teacher or a Mahatma or a so-called person of profound knowledge, in case if their behavior or activities contradict the Shruti, we should only take Shruti as the Pramanam. Shruti alone should be taken as the Pramanam. If Shruti contradicts in any context, or if Mahatma contradicts, behavior contradicts the Vedic teaching, we should take only Veda as the Pramanam. Okay? That instruction also the teacher gives here. Remember where the context? The teacher is addressing the students who are about to leave the Gurukulam to begin their lives. As Gurustas, where he remains here. Let us read this new mantra now.
Yanyanavadyani karmani. Yanyanavadyani karmani. Yanyanavadyani karmani. Yanyanavadyani karmani. Yanyanavadyani karmani. Yanyanavadyani karmani. Tani sevitau jnani. Tani sevitau jnani. Tani sevitau jnani. Tani sevitau jnani. Yanyanavadyani karmani. Yanyanavadyani karmani. Tani sevitau jnani.
Tani sevitau jnani.
No itarani. No itarani. No itarani.
No itarani.
Yanyanavadyani karmani.
Yanyanavadyani karmani.
No itarani.
No itarani.
Yanyana vadyani karmani.
Yanyana vadyani karmani.
Tani sevitau yani.
Tani sevitau yani.
No itarani.
No itarani.
Yanyasmak gusucharitani.
Yanyasmak
gusucharitani. Yanyasmak gusucharitani. Yanyasmak gusucharitani. Yanyasmak gusucharitani. Yanyasmak gusucharitani. Tani tvayopasyani. Tani tvayopasyani. Tani tvayopasyani.
Tani
tvayopasyani. No itarani.
No itarani.
No itarani.
No itarani.
Yani anavadyani karmani. If you break the line, yani anavadyani karmani. Tani sevitavyani. See, avadyam karma means an action that does not befit a Vedic student is avadyam karma. Anavadyam karma is a karma that befits a Vedic student. Which means the action, those actions which are not unbecoming. The actions which are not unbecoming. Are said to be anavadyani karmani. So, avadyam karma, anavadyam karma. You break it. Avadyam karma. Avadyani karmani. Anavadyani karmani. So, avadyam karma means a karma, an action, a behavior which does not befit a Vedic student. Which is not. Is avadyam. Anavadyam karma means this karma action behavior which befits a Vedic student. It means the actions which are not unbecoming. Actions are not unbecoming. Or anavadyani karmani, which means those actions. Yani means those which. Relative pronoun plural. Yani, those actions which are not opposed to the Vedic teaching. Which, those actions and behavior which do not contradict the Vedic way of life, Vedic injunctions. So, those actions, the behavior which do not take one away from the Vedic way of life, which will keep you in the same track of Vedic way of life. Anavadyani karmani. Is it clear? Those actions which will not take one away from the Vedic way of life. Or anavadyani karmani. Those actions. Tani sevitavyani, they must be followed. Without fail, they should be strictly followed. What should be followed? Those actions. behavior which do not take one away from the Vedic way of life, which do not contradict the Vedic teaching, should be strictly followed. Why? You know already, the Vedic way of life always is governed by Dharma, the universal law and order. Because that is, and what is it? The whole way of life is based on the value of Ahimsa. Value of Ahimsa. Ahimsa paramaha dharmaha. Ahimsa paramo dharmaha. Non-hurting, non-violence, non-injury is the most exalted of all the values. And the Vedic way of life is governed by that most exalted value of Ahimsa. Therefore, whatever Veda prescribes, Vedic way of life, what Veda prescribes as right and wrong, definitely is thoroughly clear. That's why. So what those actions and behaviors which do not contradict the Vedic teaching, which do not take one away from Vedic way of life, should be followed. Tani, those actions, sevitavyani, should be followed. That yani, tani, yani is a relative pronoun. The sentence is complete only where the sevitavyani, tani sevitavyani. So, kani sevitavyani, what are the actions, what is the behavior that should be followed? Those actions which do not take you away from Vedic teaching, Vedic way of life. Yani anavadyani, the sandhi becomes yanyanavadyani. Yanyanavadyani karmani.
Yanyanavadyani karmani.
You need not go back and look into the book. Only the meaning also should get imputed here itself in the class. That is so many times I repeat.
Yanyanavadyani karmani. Yanyanavadyani karmani.
Tani sevitau yani.
Tani sevitau yani.
No itarani.
No itarani.
Itarani means others. So those actions which do not deviate one, take one away from the Vedic way of life governed with Dharma, should be strictly followed. It means not other actions. Na itarani, not others. Not other actions which do not allow you to be in the Vedic way of life, which distract you from the Vedic way of life. So the actions which distract you, which prevent you from following the Vedic way of life, should not be followed, should not be followed.
No itarani.
No itarani.
Actually, the double emphasis, twice he said, what you should follow, what you should not follow. Na itarani means what you should not do, any action, all those actions which take one away from the Vedic way of life should not be followed. Those actions which keep you, retain you, following the Vedic way of life should be strictly followed. Therefore, Veda is the authentic, karma kanda of Veda is the authentic source of knowledge of Dharma. I will not tell you in this context, but I am really repeating again, why should I accept Veda as a pramana, karma kanda, dharma shastra as pramana? Because the whole way of life enjoying here is based on the exalted value of Ahimsa. That's why I told in the very, very beginning, nobody wants to get hurt is a universally non-refutable fact. And the way of life enjoined by the Vedic Shastram is based on this fact. Next.
Yanyanavadhyani karmani. Yanyanavadhyani karmani. Tani sevitau yani. Tani sevitau yani. No itarani. No itarani. Yanyasmak gusucharitani. Yanyasmak gusucharitani. Yanyasmak gusucharitani. Yanyasmak gusucharitani. Yanyasmak gusucharitani.
Yanyasmak gusucharitani.
Tani tvayopasyani. Tani tvayopasyani. Tani tvayopasyani.
Tani tvayopasyani.
Yanyasmak gusucharitani.
Yanyasmak
gusucharitani. Tani tvayopasyani.
Tani tvayopasyani.
No itarani.
No itarani.
No itarani.
No itarani.
Yanyasmak gusucharitani.
Yanyasmak
gusucharitani. Tani tvayopasyani.
Tani tvayopasyani.
No itarani.
No itarani.
No. Yani asmak g is a asmakam. For meaning, when you only for chanting, you can say yani asmak g sucharitani. So it's a Vedic usage. For convention, when you break the words for meaning, yani asmakam sucharitani. Yani asmakam sucharitani. Tani tvaya upasyani. Tani tvaya upasyani. Tani tvaya upasyani. Got it? Yani asmakam sucharitani. Tani tvaya upasyani. Again, tani tvaya upasyani. Tani tvaya upasyani. Those actions should be followed by you as a rule. Shankara Bhagavatpada in his commentary adds, Niyamena means what? As a rule, those actions should be followed. Tani tvaya upasyani by you. When the teacher is addressing the student, by you, tvaya, those actions, those behaviors should be niyamena sevitavyani. They must be strictly followed by you as a rule. What should be followed by you as a rule? Yanyasmak gusucharitani. He says, yani, those actions and behavior. Here, sucharitani. Sucharitam here replies the noble, righteous, appropriate actions and behavior of our own elders, our teachers, our rishis. Asmakam means our. But here we have to separate. Shankaracharya in his commentary, here it writes, who that asmakam, he writes here, acharyanam sucharitani. So sucharitani, when you take it, acharyanam, we understand from Shankaracharya's commentary. So sucharitani, noble, righteous, appropriate actions, which are in conformity with Vedic injunctions, and those and followed by our own teachers. And so highly learned, the profound scholars who live, the our teachers who live, and their noble actions, their behavior should be followed as a rule. Tani tvaya upasyani yani asmakam sucharitani. Sucharitani means what? The noble actions, righteous actions, noble behavior of our teachers, observing them, should be followed as a rule.
Yanyasmakagusucharitani tanitvayopasyani no itarani.
There the doubt may come. Not others, not other actions, which are not noble, which are not appropriate. Those actions should, inappropriate actions should not be followed, even if they are followed by your teachers. Even the teachers will not follow, even if the teachers happen to, sometimes it could happen to be wrong also, and we should not follow them. Whatever the teacher follows, if that is in conformity with the teaching, then I follow that. Even the teacher's behavior, somewhere it contradicts the way the teaching, I do not follow. One should not follow. No itarani. That second no itarani is for what? Those actions and behavior of teacher also, if they are not in conformity with the teaching, should not be followed. Understand? No itarani. How many times repeated? Veda, Dharma Shastram should be taken as means of knowledge. Always should see the positive and the right side of the person and take the right aspects. If at all there is anything negative about the person, and then even if it is acharya, ignore it, don't follow that. There are no compromise. You can compromise with anything, but no compromise with Dharma. No way. The whole Vedic teaching is but Karma Yoga itself. No compromise with Dharma. My own personal likes and dislikes, whatever they always, we only want to do what we want to do. I do because I like to do. I do not do because I don't like to do. Which means our actions are what? You know, our actions are only expressions of our own personal views and fancies. Expressions of our own likes and dislikes. And when they completely doubt by my own likes and dislikes, then I do not even mind going against Dharma. Then, as a result, what happens? I fulfill my desires, but I transgress values. I disturb the order. I go against them. It's called wrong action. It's a papa karma. Okay, disturb the order. So that is why even oh my teacher, how can I'm so emotionally entangled? He taught me so many good things. How can he taught a good thing, but when he goes wrong, we should not follow. Because teaching should become, that is why Vedic teaching, there's no hero worshipping. There's no hero worshipping. There's no one person supervising. Always Vedic wisdom. Vedic Shastram is the Pramana, guide. And which is timeless scripture. Any teacher can enjoy respect for the teaching that is going through the person. Wisdom, nobody can claim the wisdom as one's own. It's like from big reservoir of water, the water is flowing through the pipes. The pipe can never say, I only give water, you know. Only through the pipe the water is flowing, and then no teacher can claim any credit. Gratefully, politely, give the credit to the parampara. What should be taken finally? Shastra Jnana, Shastra. That's why first he says, Asmakam Sucharitani. We have to take all the noble activities, noble behavior, appropriate actions, right actions, which do not contradict the Vedic teaching of our teachers, should be followed as a rule. No hitarani, but even a teacher's actions also, suppose if they are against the values, they should not be followed. Contradicts the teaching.
Yanyasmakagussucharitani Tanitvayopasyani No itarani Yeke chasma chreyakum so brahmana. Yeke chasma chreyakum so brahmana.
Yeke
chasma chreyakum so chasma chreyakum so Chasmachreyagumso.
Chasmachreyagumso.
What's here? We have Yekhe Chaumachreya.
I think you are chanting Ye, you may correct it, maybe. Correct it.
Yeah.
For chanting, for breaking Ye, Ke, Chasmachreyagumso.
Yes.
Break it, tell you first. Ye, ke, cha, asmat. Ye, first break and write, then it will be easy for you. Ye, ke, cha, asmat. Four words now. Ye, ke, cha, asmat. Shreyam saha. Shreyam saha. Shreyam saha. Then brahmanaha. Separate word. I repeat again. Ye. Ke. Cha. Ye ke cha. Say. Ye ke cha. Asmat.
Asmat.
Ye ke cha asmat.
Yeke
chasmat.
Yeke
chasmat.
Shreyam Saha.
Shreyam Saha.
Yeke Chasmat Shreyam Saha.
Yeke
Chasmat Shreyam Saha. There the after ya, there's a boom sound comes this way. For chanting, Yeke Chasmat Shreya Gumso. 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 Brahmanah. Brahmanah. Yeke Chasmat Shreya Gumso. Brahmanah.
Yeke
Chasmat Shreya Gumso. Brahmanah. Tesham. Tesham. Tvayasanena.
Tvayasanena.
Tesham.
Tesham.
Tvayasanena.
Tvayasanena.
Prashvasitavyam. Prashvasitavyam. Yeke Chasmat Shreya Gumso. Brahmanah.
Yeke Chasmat Shreya Gumso. Brahmanah.
Tesham Tvayasanena Prashvasitavyam.
Tesham Tvayasanena Prashvasitavyam.
Now, ye ke cha. Ye those who. Now, ye ke means those whoever. Those whoever means those people whoever are left. Apart from those who have been earlier listed. As Mata, Pita, Guru, Acharya, Atithi.
Yes.
These are how, what sort of attitude we should have towards all of them. Towards the mother, towards father, towards teacher, towards Atithi. They have been mentioned. Now, even other people. There are many other people in the society who do not come under the list of those people who were mentioned earlier, who are not relatives or family members or known people, but still, and yekecha, other people who are also asmat. Asmat means than us. Shreyam Saha. Shreyam means who are Shreyam Saha, more experienced. Who are superior to us in experience or in academic knowledge or in very deep knowledge. Who are superior to us, who are elders and who know, who are more experienced. Okay, and who are also Brahmanaha. Brahmanaha means who are profound, men of profound wisdom. Well, men of profound wisdom, profound knowledge. Therefore, who are committed to live the life of Dharma. Other people. There are many other people in society who also must be having knowledge of the scriptures. Who also must be highly revered, who are also exalted, who are also committed to live a life of Dharma, and who are definitely superior to us in terms of knowledge and experience. Shreyamsa. even such people also asmat shreyam saha, who are better, who are more experienced, who are more knowledgeable, who are also committed to dharma, who also have performed the scriptures, even such people also, even if they are not known to us, still they also should be revered equally. How we revere our parents, revere our teacher, revere our guests, even those people also should be equally revered. They also deserve that respect and reverence. Not only people who are known to me. The only people. It doesn't matter who it is. The unknown person also, if you come to know the person is a profound knowledge, experienced, and the person is committed to dharma, then naturally, then there must be respect. So, yekecha asmat shreyam saha. Okay, shreyam saha means who are superior to us, better than us. How? In terms of experience, in terms of knowledge, in terms of understanding of the teaching, and because of which they are committed to live a life of values. So such people also, brahmanaha, and then they must be revered. The shastra looks at who is a brahmana, whoever follows strictly dharma is a brahmana. And tesham, they must, even Shankar Bhagavatpada writes, but they must, suppose if such people, they must be revered. Means, if they come also, they must be welcomed with respect. And in order to help them get over their tiredness, we must provide a seat for them. Please come, take your seat. And they're hungry, you can even provide them some food, give them something to drink, to relax. This is how they also must be revered, treated respectfully. So here, this much is implied here, not mentioned there, but implied. And then, tesham tvayam asanena prashvasitavyam. And Shankaracharya writes here, tesham tvayasane na prashvasitavyam. Next line, tesham tvayasane na prashvasitavyam, tesham tvayasane na prashvasitavyam, na prashvasitavyam. Literally it means you should not breathe. What does it mean, my God? Should I hold the breath in front of them? I'll die. No. What it means is you should not breathe the word. You should not breathe a word. You should not breathe the word means what? You must remain silent in their presence. It means when I should remain silent, when they come, when you happen to see them, welcome them, give them water, give them food, give them seat, make them feel comfortable, do something to help them get over their tiredness, is all expression of your respect. Suppose such brahmanaha, such men of profound wisdom, when they gather, Shankaracharya writes in his commentary, okay, you should not breathe the word, that should be explained. Then, and that same people, if they happen to assemble for discussing the meaning of the words of the Shastra, and he writes, it's called Goshti. Goshti itself, nowadays in India, the word Goshti is used in the wrong sense, a gang. They say the gangsters, no, after they say Goshti,
In fact, the word Goshti is a beautiful meaning in Sanskrit. Shankaracharya writes, Goshti means where people meet for discussing the right meaning of the words of any Shastra. The meeting of scholars to discuss with a mutual respect to each other, not to whom I am right, you are wrong, not to that. The meeting of scholars, men of profound wisdom, with a mutual respect for discussing the, with discussing to arrive at the right meaning, to arrive at the right meaning of the words of any scripture, any Shastra. Because it's doubt, they have to get the doubts resolved. So they must arrive at the conclusion, what is the right meaning of the words. For such, so all of them together, come together, assemble, and to discuss in order to arrive at the right meaning of the words of any Shastra. Called Goshti. And when they are Goshti, they assemble, and because, well, with the good intention you receive, okay. Now with the good intention, meaning well also, when they are involved in such discussion, we should not get up and walk up and down, we should not be disturbing, we should not be talking, even to help them also we should not be doing anything. Because it's not appropriate behavior according to the Shastra. We should keep keeping a low profile without talking anything, remaining silent. What should we do? Shankaracharya writes, one must try to grasp the essence of their discussion. One must try to grasp the essence of their discussion. It means we should listen and others should speak. What a teaching. In those days, even in India, always in front of father, son doesn't speak. In front of grandparents, as the grandfather. Keep quiet. In this way also keep quiet. With respect. Nobody should talk, but there's a different thing. In the same means, just listen. The Veda says, just obey. Why? Mata, mother, Shruti Mata. She means well. So here, Tesham Twaya Asane Na Prashvasitavya. Tesham Twaya Asane Na Prashvasitavya. When they are seated in assembly to discuss for arriving at the meaning, right meaning of the words of any Shastra, one must remain silent, try to grasp the essence of their discussion. So without interfering, without causing any disturbance. Okay. Yeke chasmat chayarum so brahmanaha. Yeke chasmat chayarum so brahmanaha. Tesham twayasanena prashvasitavyam. Tesham twayasanena prashvasitavyam. Yeke chasmat chayarum so brahmanaha. Chasmachreyagum so brahmana tesham twayasanena prashvasitavyam
Tesham Vayasanena Prashvasitauryam.
How? What should be our attitude towards what's happening? We understood. Well, how should we behave? That has been said in the previous. Next. Now, dana. Dana means giving. Of course, dana is an important action, giving, sharing. Of course, student gives dakshina after his studies. Otherwise, when a ritual is performed, dakshina is given to the priest. Or for any good cause, like ashrams and or other public work, always for good causes, always donations are requested, donations are given. When something is given, I'm not talking about people who cheat now, okay? Generally, when we, there's an act of giving for supporting any good cause, how should we give? That is discussed here. As a Vaidika, how should he be? What should be his attitude? How should he be giving?
Shraddhaya deyam, shraddhaya deyam, shraddhaya deyam, shraddhaya deyam, ashraddhaya deyam, ashraddhaya deyam, ashraddhaya deyam, ashraddhaya deyam, shriya deyam, shriya deyam, shriya deyam, shriya deyam, kriya deyam, kriya deyam, kriya deyam, kriya deyam, kriya deyam, kriya deyam, samvida deyam, samvida deyam.
Just for understanding dana alone, we have few lines here. When a charity is given, how should it be given? Because a householder should have this duty of giving. Even giving is an important duty of a household. Rest, not only performing rituals, not only being worshipful, not only being prayerful, not only having proper attitude, not only even following ethics, following values, even the important duty of a grihastha is giving, sharing. In fact, of all the people, of all the ashramas, this grihastha is the one who must be giving. The sannyasi is penniless, not earning, not earning number. He cannot give. And a brahmachari, of course, is a student, he is not an earner. The vanaprasthi already hand over things to his children. Grihastha must be the giver. Well, all of them should try to give, but grihastha giving is a must on the part of a grihastha, householder. Therefore, how should the charity be given?
Shraddhaya deyam, shraddhaya deyam.
Small words. Nice.
Shraddhaya Deyam Ashraddhaya Deyam Ashraddhaya Deyam Ashraddhaya Deyam Ashraddhaya Deyam Shriya Deyam Shriya Deyam Kriya Deyam Kriya Deyam Bhriya Deyam Bhriya Deyam Samvida Deyam Samvida Deyam.
So when the chant is given, Shraddhaya Deyam, it should be, Deyam means to be given, should be given. How Shraddhaya? Means with the Shraddha. With Shraddha means what? Have, suppose a person who gives must have faith in the Vedic teaching. As a householder, when he gives, having faith in the Vedic injections, Vedic teaching, he must give. He must have Shraddha in the Vedic Shastra. I don't believe, I don't trust this Veda, I don't go care for Veda. But anyway, I have money, somebody has come, let me give. With that attitude, one should not give. With that thinking, one should not give. Even though that person gives, should not receive also. In giving, there must be faith. Because when something is given as a charity for a good cause, for a noble cause, it must be given with Shraddha in the teaching of the Veda. For Shraddhaya Deyam. Shraddhaya Deyam. Then, Chakrata says, Ashraddhaya Adeyam. When he gives, it is my duty to give for a good cause. And giving for a good cause is what is going to contribute for my antakarna shuddhi or mental purification. It's going to earn punyam for me. Shastram says, so I give wholeheartedly, respectfully, I give with Shraddha. What? Shraddhaya Deyam. Charity must be given with great respect and with faith in the teaching of the Vedic Shastra. Shraddhaya Deyam. Then, Ashraddhaya Adeyam. Your next sentence, you must take it, you can break it. Ashraddhaya Deyam. You break it. Ashraddhaya Adeyam. So it should not be given without Shraddha, faith in the Vedic teaching. Ashraddhaya Adeyam means any dana, any charity should not be given charity should not be given without faith in the Vedic teaching and without respect for the receiver also. When you give, definitely the person who gives, I am giving, so he is receiving. There should not, we should not, without looking down upon the receiver, the respect for the receiver that he gives me an opportunity to give. There is no receiver, he cannot become a giver. So the respect for the receiver, with the faith in the teaching alone, it should be given. And without respect for the receiver, without having faith in the teaching, very teaching, dana should not be given. For Shraddhaya Deyam, Ashraddhaya Adeyam. But there is another great commentator of the entire Veda. This Vashyam called Shayana Vashyam. Shayanacharya. But he writes, without Shraddha also give, because it's hard to give. So give without Shraddha, and gradually by giving, it will create shabda in you.
Better to give than not giving is better than not giving. So the stinginess, miserliness, isn't it? Not want to share anything with others, that will go. So at least even without heart also try to give. So gradually you will have the attitude of sharing. Then that it also will create what? Even if initially you give without respect, then gradually you will develop respect, you develop sadhya. It's better, giving is better than not giving. But giving with respect is better than simply giving. First he says, well, there's two means. Shabdaya, adeyam, shabdaya, ashraddaya, adeyam, ashraddaya, deyam. You can take it two ways. Okay. Ashraddaya, deyam, ashraddaya, deyam, shriya, deyam, shriya, deyam. Then shrihi means literally means wealth. But here, Shriya Deyam, when charity is given for a noble cause, good cause, knowing what the cause is, in keeping with my capacity, I should give. So the Dhanam should be given in keeping with the capacity of the giver. Knowing the value and the nobility of the cause. The person who has more can give more. The person who doesn't have anything can give little. Isn't it? That's not almost we're giving. There's another expression, some other context. Yakshanusaram balihi. When you do an offering, you invite Bakasura. Bakasura, you know, Bakasura is a demon. He is a huge demon. He comes and for him just water food was cooked and keep. He made Bakasura for lunch and gave him on 3 grapes. That's not offering, is it? Offering is Yakshanusaram Balihi. Your offering must be in keeping with who you are offering to. Like the Dhanam also, when for noble cause, in the noble thing, purpose, when the charity is given, and suppose give wholeheartedly, knowing the cause, and keeping with one's to your capacity. So give abundantly, generously. So Shriya Deya means generously must be given. The charity must be given generously in keeping with your capacity for any good cause. Suppose if I myself don't have, how can I give? There's no problem. We know what the giver knows what he has. One must give generously, abundantly, keep one's capacity, to the best of one's ability for any supporting any good cause. Therefore, Shriya Deyam, Shriya Deyam. Kriya Deyam, Kriya Deyam. Krihi means shyness, modesty. But Kriya Deyam means when charity is given, it is given with the modesty, the politeness and the humility. Oh, I can only give this much. Look at that. How should we give it? You will give 10 rupees and some few dollars and give also, then I want to be aggressive. I didn't get aggressive. I didn't get aggressive. Of course, asking for this to make an account. That's the thing. Sometimes people want to make the whole world know what they have given. So here, the idea is, Kriya Deya means, charity must be given with the modesty, with the humility,
I wish I could give more. I can only give this much. With that thinking, it must be given.
Kriya deyam, kriya deyam, kriya deyam, kriya deyam, kriya deyam, kriya deyam.
Means the person does not give arrogantly. No, I am giving. The other person is receiving. So in giving charity, arrogance should not be expressed. There must be, let's say, politeness, humility, and modesty in giving. Now, bhya, bhihi means fear. Shrihi, krihi, bhihi, all these are stilingi shabdas, feminine gender words. Bhihi means fear. See, the word shrihi literally means wealth, literally means beauty, literally means splendor. Different meanings. So we take it in the context how it should be given. Okay? Then bhyadeyam means, bhya means, literally it means with fear. I tell you, it should not be really, when you give dhanam, when charity is given, it should not be given with fear.
Oh my God,
I should give one. Not that way. When with fear means, again, I'm afraid what I give is enough or not. That I have to. Not that fear geometric, literally as fear. I'm afraid what I'm giving is appropriate or not, enough or not. So, bhya deyam. Then samvida deyam, samvida deyam, samvida deyam,
samvida deyam.
So when you say bhya deyam, so giving with the great concern also. Now, samvida deyam. Samvit means, in fact, samvit is a beautiful word. Samvit is another word for pure consciousness, pure knowledge. I want to know the word. Like chit, chitihi, chaitanyam. They are all synonyms. Like samvit also means consciousness. But here, samvit means simple knowledge. Knowledge here. So samvida deyam means when charity is given, definitely we should know who the recipient is. The knowledge of the recipient, the knowledge of the cause what I am giving it for, and without making the other person feel obligated. Without any strings attached, any demand in return, just dana charity should be given with a friendly nature. Samvida means friendliness. Even if a person who receives a stranger. So knowing the recipient. And again, knowing the recipient, knowing the cause. So give it without being given with the friendliness, the friendly attitude, friendly nature. And making the person feel comfortable, without making the person feel obligated, without any demand in return, there is strings attached. Give and forget about it. this Samvida Deyam.
Shraddhaya Deyam, Shraddhaya Deyam, Ashraddhaya Deyam, Ashraddhaya Deyam, Shriya Deyam, Shriya Deyam, Kriya Deyam, Kriya Deyam, Bhriya Deyam, Bhriya Deyam, Samvida Deyam, Samvida Deyam.
So, just discussing only about the charity, how it should be given. Now, Upanishad moves on to the next instruction of the teacher. As I said, how we take Veda, Karma Kanda of the Veda, as the authentic source of knowledge of Dharma. We also accept Smriti Grantha as a source of knowledge of Dharma. And even Shishtacharaha, the people of profound knowledge of scriptures and whose lives align with the Shastra, and even they should be approached for guidance. So we know what is right and what is wrong. But sometimes, it is right, white. It is wrong, this black. But sometimes gray. How should I take it? Then there's a doubt comes. So in a given situation, the doubt comes, what I should do. I'm going to decide. Then always approach elders and who live the Shastra. Because of the experience, and they can all go capable of making appropriate decisions, appropriate conclusions, appropriately interpret the situation, analyze the situation, and appropriately arrive at the decision. How? Because of their profound knowledge of the scriptures, because of the experience also, they are capable of analyzing the situations, interpreting the property, interpreting the situations. Such people should be approached. That's what is here, the instruction. Next instruction the teacher gives. Okay, if you stop here, if you give some time for questions, I'll continue this.
Athayadite karma vichikitsa va. Karma vichikitsa va vritta vichikit vritta vichikitsa va syat vritta vichikitsa va syat athayadite karma vichikitsa va karma vichikitsa va vritta vichikitsa va syat vritta vichikitsa va syat athayadite karma vichikitsa va karma vichikitsa va vritta vichikitsa va syat vritta vichikitsa va syat yetatra brahmana sammarshinah brahmana sammarshinah yetatra brahmana sammarshinah yetatra brahmana sammarshinah yukta ayukta yukta ayukta yukta ayukta
kamasyuho,
dharma kamasyuho,
aloksha dharma kamasyuho,
aloksha dharma
kamasyuho, aloksha dharma kamasyuho,
aloksha dharma kamasyuho,
aloksha dharma kamasyuho,
aloksha dharma kamasyuho,
yatha te tatra varteran,
yatha te tatra varteran,
yatha te tatra varteran,
yatha
te tatra varteran, tatha tatra vartethah,
tatha
tatra vartethah, yatha te tatra varteran,
yatha
te tatra varteran, tatha tatra vartethah,
tatha tatra vartethah,
tatha tatra vartethah,
tatha tatra vartethah.
Okay. Here, atha, then the teacher says, yadi, if, yadi means if, stay for you or you have, yani, vichikitsa means doubt. If there is a doubt for you, in what? Karma. Karma means in action. Karma vichikitsa means doubts regarding actions or performance of rituals. In activities, karma vichikitsa, doubts in actions, doubts in performing rituals, or vritta vichikitsa. Vichikitsa, doubt. In vritta, in conduct. Vritta vichikitsa. Suppose doubt is there. Karma vichikitsa or vritta vichikitsa. Any doubt you have, what we should do? He says, vichikitsa vasya. If at all, then if you have any doubt in karma or vritta, then there are people, you approach those people. When you are not able to really decide what I should do here, what I should not do, what is appropriate, what is inappropriate, I am doubtful, I have doubt. I don't know how, what I should really do. Such a situation is ye tatra brahmanaha. Those people who are there, tatra means who are there in that time, in that place, that situation. People who are there in that place, in that time. And who are they? Brahmanaha, people who have performed knowledge of scriptures. Not only they have performed knowledge of scriptures, sammarshinaha. Sammarshinaha means vicharakshamaha. People who are able to analyze the situations in the light of their clear knowledge, in the light of their clear vision of the Shastram, who are able to analyze the situations, who are able to interpret the situation, who are able to arrive at the right conclusions, such people. And yuktaha, who are endowed with the knowledge of those, then ayuktaha. Ayuktaha means
people who themselves are informed, therefore who are not dependent on others, other consultants. Okay, who are independent of others for any consultancy. Such people, ayuktaha. Not only that, alokshaha. Alokshaha means who are not cunning, cruel minded. And who are compassionate, who are considerate. See, once Shastra Jnanam is there, they can't afford to be cunning and cruel. They must be considerate. Must be concerned, must have great concern, and they must be considerate, they must be compassionate, they must be really, you know, that's people who are not cruel minded, cunning minded, who are compassionate and considerate, who care, they carry people, alokshaha, dharma kamaha. Dharma kamaha means who are totally committed to the life of values, or committed to values, dharma. Therefore, who are not easily afflicted by their own likes and dislikes and desires. And that's people are highly non-judgmental. People are non-judgmental. Okay, such people, yatha, they tatra vartenan. How those people are dealing with situations, how they are there, how they are dealing with situations, how they are there. So observing them, how they are dealing, how they are handling, how they are doing things, accordingly may you also be there. May also tata tatra vartte taha. May you be like those people. May you tackle situation how they tackle. You handle situation how they handle. You also take their guidance. And they'll be kind enough to help you. They will interpret the situation appropriately. Isn't it? This is the teaching. So, karma vichikitsava, vritta vichikitsava, yadi syat. If you have any doubt. So, whatever is the doubt? Karma vichikitsa or vritta vichikitsa? Doubt regarding the right conduct in life. Doubt regarding the performance of rituals, doubt regarding knowing nothing, even big activities. Any doubt you have, then see those people who are ye tatra brahmanaha, samvarshinaha, yuktaha, ayuktaha. Yuktaha, they are not only they're knowledgeable, they're also experienced. Always elders are revered, respected in India mainly for the experience. They are being very young. Experience not being enough, exposure being not enough, definitely sometimes experienced people are more knowledgeable. But experience, yuktaha. So, ayuktaha, the independent of other people, do not approach others for any consultancy. So, highly discriminative people. And such people, dharma kamaha, who are also committed to dharma, therefore who are not easily affected by, who are not at all affected by desires, other emotions, who are perfect mastery of their thoughts also. That's non-judgmental people, how they are in that situations, how they approach the situations, how they handle the situations, may you also follow them. Tatha tatra te vartetaha. May you also be there like how they are. That is the, may you conduct yourself in the situation in such a manner how they conduct themselves. How, what they would do in such situation. So follow them. It's called Sishtachara sitting Shishtacharaha, the conduct of men of wisdom. Should be taken as guidance, as a means of knowledge. Atha yadi te karma vichikitsa va vritta vichikitsa va syat. Atha yadi te karma vichikitsa va vritta vichikitsa va syat. Atha yadi te karma vichikitsa va vritta vichikitsa va syat. Karma vichikitsa va vritta vichikitsa va syat. Te ye tatra brahmana sammarshinah.
Ye tatra
brahmana sammarshinah. Yukta ayuktaah,
yukta ayuktaah,
aloksha dharma kamasyuh,
aloksha dharma kamasyuh,
aloksha dharma kamasyuh,
aloksha dharma kamasyuh,
yatha te tatra vartheran.
Tatha
tatra vartethaah,
tatha tatra
vartethaah,
tatha tatra vartethaah.
Athaabhya akhyateshu, athaabhya akhyateshu. Athaabhya akhyateshu, athaabhya akhyateshu. Only one new word, okay? Same thing is going to be repeated. Athaabhya akhyateshu, athaabhya akhyateshu. Yetatra brahmana sammarshinah.
Yetatra brahmana sammarshinah.
Yukta ayuktaah,
yukta ayuktaah,
aloksha dharma kamasyuh,
aloksha dharma kamasyuh.
Yatha te teshu vartheran,
yatha te teshu vartheran,
tatha teshu vartethaah,
tatha teshu vartethaah.
Yesha adeshah,
yesha adeshah,
esha upadeshah,
esha upadeshah.
Yesha vedopanishat,
yesha vedopanishat.
Yetadanushasanam,
yetadanushasanam.
Yevamupasitavyam,
yevamupasitavyam.
Yevamuchaitadupasyam,
yevamuchaitadupasyam.
Yevamuchaitadupasyam,
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 yevamuchaitadupasyam.
Two lines, I think the karma can go. I had a thought of completing it, but then you should go about the head, on the toes. We do come back and we conclude this 11th section. Okay?
I hope you are enjoying. Okay, Dharma Shastra will be over soon.
Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tatsat Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om.